Well, several cars have been destroyed after an electric car burst into flames at Sydney Airport.
For more on this, we're joined by New South Wales Fire Service Superintendent Adam Dewberry and James Ward from drive.com.au. Firstly, to you, Superintendent, thank you for joining us this morning.
Yeah, good morning.
This caused significant damage. What was behind the explosion?
Yeah, five cars. So what we had was a vehicle that was in a holding yard. It wasn't a car park, it was actually a holding yard.
Okay.
And the vehicle was broken down. And someone has removed the battery some time ago, and that battery had suffered some damage, whether it was from an accident or hitting some debris on the road. And it was then left next to the vehicle, which had caught fire. The battery had been ruptured or was open during impact somewhere, and water was able to get in. Then it did catch fire, and we know the story that it's had five cars destroyed. Luckily, the airport rescue and firefighting service were close by. They were able to respond quickly with our fire truck from Botany and were able to get on top of
that. Jeez, it must have been on like Donkey Kong, though. There's a lot of damage. And
yeah, there was. I mean, cars, electric, petrol, diesel, they ignite. Once they're ignited, they burn hot and they can spread rapidly.
We're told that these things are pretty safe. We've been pushed towards them more and more.
Yeah.
Are you getting a lot of incidents like this?
No, they're very safe. Very safe technology. Very few. I think there's about 150,000 in New South Wales, and I see a lot of incidents and hear a lot of incidents of note, but very rarely do we have anything with electric vehicles.
Mm. Well, let's bring in James from drive.com.au. I mean, when you look at pictures like that, James, you do worry about these electric vehicles, but do you reckon they're safe too?
Yeah, look, I'm just wondering what more I can add, because I'm just nodding and saying, yeah, that all checks out. They aren't as highly represented in fire stakes as petrol and diesel cars. And I think it's one of those things, because electric cars are new, if one is involved in a fire, it's more of a story than a petrol car. And normally you see it where the cars are charging or something. There's usually something that triggers the fire. And obviously in this case, they're not like a power drill. You don't pull the battery out to charge it. That battery has been removed, and the only reason you would do that is if there has been damage caused to the battery. So it's a very isolated circumstance for that to happen.
You'd be across some of the data from overseas, though, and the more of these cars we get into the country, the more concern there's going to be that something like this might happen. Is there anything that residents at home are warned about when they get an electric vehicle?
Look, the trick is obviously, because you're dealing with electricity, just making sure that your charging setup is as safely installed as it can possibly be. So you're not there with frayed wires, with lower quality wires. If there's water getting into it, that could be bad. But obviously, if your car has had any impact, whether it's a minor traffic incident or you've hit a rock on the road and you are worried about it, do get it checked out, because that's where you may get a battery cell ruptured. But these things are designed to be very strong. They're designed to be impact resistant. So there's a lot of thought going into this process. And it really is an isolated case like this where something happens.
Okay.
But as we saw, they do burn hot and they do tend to run away.
All right, Adam, just quickly before you go, let's have a look at the Skycam in Sydney this morning and your personnel have been called out. That looks actually worse in Sydney than it has in the last couple of days, apparently clearing the next 24 hours. But that's pretty bad. How have you been with all the smoke alarms going off?
Look, we've had a lot of smoke alarms activate overnight, and in a way that's a good thing, because that's the system's working. They're designed to be sensitive to give us early notification of fire. Unfortunately, because of the hazard reduction we have to do, Rural Fire Service and Fire Rescue New South Wales have to do to make the community safer as we prepare for the summer, we just have to work through this. We are asking people to be patient with us. Don't be complacent. Just because your alarm's gone off, don't turn them off, don't move them, don't be complacent.
Good on you. Lovely to see you. Thank you.
Thanks,
and thank you, James. Appreciate it.